guys, how's it going? Laura with Garden Answer. In today's video, I want to talk to you about a program that I'm going to be participating in this year called Garden to Give. So as you guys know, we work a lot with Gardner's Supply Company, and they have started this program with the hope of inspiring as many people as possible to grow a vegetable garden and then to donate a portion of their harvest to their local food banks or food pantries to help out those in need. So this video is just going to be about how the program works and how you can get involved. And I really encourage you guys to join me because I just think it's so important for us to be giving back to our communities and helping other people out wherever we can. And chances are, if you're already growing a vegetable garden, you probably already have extra produce hanging around that could be donated. And just to kind of bring it home for you guys, the USDA reports that over 41 million people, 13 million of which are kids, have struggled with hunger, yet 11.4 billion pounds of garden produce has ended up as food waste every single year. And I just think that is so sad, wasteful, and really unnecessary when those people could be benefiting from that produce. So I've decided to pledge to grow and donate a portion of my vegetables for my raised beds this year. And some really great things to plant to donate that have a really good shelf life are things like onions, beets, carrots, potatoes, things like that. But there's other crops like lettuce, beans, and tomatoes that are usually equally as welcome, but it's a really good idea to contact your local food pantry and see what things that they are in need of the most. Now, if you aren't sure where your local food bank or food pantry is, you can visit ampleharvest.org, click Find a Pantry, put your zip code in, click Search Locations, and it'll give you a whole list of all the food banks and food pantries that are closest to you. And I actually think this is a great part to get your kids involved in. Like, take a field trip down to your local food pantry, talk with them about what their needs are, show your kids kind of how it works. I just think it's never too early to start showing your kids how to give back to their communities and help out others. So if this sounds like something that you want to be involved in, you can take the pledge right along with me by filling out the form on Gardner Supply's website. And actually, starting this month and for each month for the rest of the year, they're going to be choosing one winner to give a $100 gift card to. And you can even order seeds for a pre-planned giving garden from High Mowing Organic Seeds. And you can see the giving garden design on Gardner Supply's website. It's for a 4x8 area, and what it's meant to do is help you kind of maximize the efficiency and the output of your space so you can get the maximum amount of produce. And everything that's in that plan is designed to mature at the same time, so it only involves one big trip down to your local food pantry. There's also an opportunity to help out your food bank monetarily by participating in the Show What You Share photo contest, which will start in August. So what you'll do is you'll take a picture of yourself with the food that you donate to your food bank, and one winner will receive a $500 Gardner Supply gift card, and Gardner Supply Company will donate $1,000 to that winner's local food bank. For more info on that, be sure to follow Gardner Supply on social media, both Instagram and Facebook, for more details on the contest as the date gets closer. So that's it. I just want to encourage you guys one more time to join me and pledge to Garden to Give this year. I think it's a really great program. I think it's going to really help people out. Thank you guys so much for taking the time to watch this video, and we will see you in the next one. Bye.